Today for lunch, we're having taco soup, sweet potato fries, veggie cup, crackers, and fruit. Tomorrow, we're having hot pocket, side with ranch, corn, and fruit. Wednesday, we're having soft taco, side with ranch, pinto beans, and fruit. Thursday, we're having hot dog, french fries, baked beans, veggie cup, and fruit. And Friday, we're having chicken nuggets, cream of tatas, English peas, roll, and fruit. Today for breakfast, we're having yogurt, fruit, and milk. Tomorrow, we're having cinnamon raisin biscuit, fruit, and milk. Wednesday, we're having waffle sticks, fruit, and milk. Thursday, we're having donut, fruit, and milk. And Friday, we're having Pop-Tart, fruit, and milk. I want to give a big shout-out to Miss Vicki Brown's homeroom class for racing the most pop-tops. Congratulations. I'm here with your school news. Have a roaring good week.
There's a track meet at Russellville, Alabama, Tuesday, March 17, 2015. Yes, St. Patrick's Day. Maybe we can get lucky and win the pot of gold. Baseball Saturday 21st, 2015. The baseball is at Russellville, Alabama. The Haleville travel team won the Curry Invitational Championship. Pitcher was Carly Dozier, catcher Kinsley Frederick and Sadie Tittle. Shortstop Katie Aldridge and Reagan Phillips. Third base was Kinsley Frederick. Second base was Lily Tinch and Emma Parson. First base is Reagan Swims. Left field, MC, short for Mary Caroline. Center field was Lily Ray Rushing. Right field was Megan McCullough. Coach was Kyle Rushing. Assistant coach, his name is Bubba. Have a roaring good week.
Temps gave way to beautiful blue skies and warm weather, which made for perfect conditions for local volunteers to bag 8,400 pounds of apples, which were donated by Crow Mountain Orchards to add local food ministries. Around 100 volunteers of all ages representing local churches gathered on Saturday morning to bag the apples into 5-pound bags to be distributed by area churches. 12 churches from Haleville, Double Swings, Arley, Gune, and Russellville were on hand to accept the fruit to be distributed through ministries. In other news, Haleville High School varsity cheerleaders for 2015 through 16 is Carly Banks, Lauren Belcher, Adrina Frost, Anna Langotzi, Kinsley Knight, Claire Leitman, Molly Morris, Hannah Rayburn, Chloe Tolbert, Nicole Whitman. Congrats. I'm here with your local news. Have a roaring good week.
Let's drop!
Yeah! 20HS, I'm doing your weekly roar with a forecast. Have you recovered from all the winter weather and all the rain we've had over the last 3 weeks? This week will start off beautifully with lots of sun and mild temperatures. All week will be sunny with a few clouds in the sky. Highs will be in the mid to upper 60s and low to mid 70s. Lows will be in the low to mid 40s. This has been your weekly World Weather Forecast. Have a great week and more lines.
Dragons may sound like mythical creatures from a fairy tale, but these tiny fish that are close cousins of seahorses and pipefish do exist. Found in the coastal waters of southern and western Australia, the gorgeous creatures that feed off tiny crustaceans, plankton, and larva fishes do not have teeth or stomach. They therefore have to eat constantly and are always scurrying the oceans in search of prey. Until recently, scientists have believed that there were only two species of sea dragons: Leafy, which sports large and flowing leaf-like branches on its body, and Weedy, that has much smaller leaf-like appendages. Turns out that there's a third species, one scientists have decided to call Ruby, thanks to its stunning dark red color. The discovery of the newest member of the sea dragon family is the result of a collaboration between Josephine Steeler and Greg Rouse from the Scripps Institute of Oceanography in San Diego, California, and marine biologist Narita Wilson of the Western Australia Museum. Next in the news, it all began innocently enough. On Thursday, February 26, 21-year-old Scottish singer Caitlin McNeil posed a simple question along with a photo of a dress on the social media website Tumblr. It says, "Guys, please help me. Is this dress white and gold or black and blue?" Little did she know that this simple question would set off an internet firestorm. As the photo began to circulate across various social media sites, the dress became the center of a worldwide debate. Some firmly believed it was blue and black, while others clearly saw it as white and gold. So who was right, and why did millions of people see colors so far from reality? According to experts, the confusion over the colors of the dress has to do with the way the image is taken. People see the dress differently because of their sensitivity to the blue background lighting in the photo. The dress is creating a similar optical illusion. According to David Williams, professor of medical optics and director of the Center for Visual Science, the controversy is a result of the confusing lighting around the dress. He thinks that it's not giving the brain usual clues on how to interpret its colors. As a consequence, people that perceive the background as brightly illuminated conclude that the dress is made of a darker material and see it as blue and black. However, others see it poorly lit setting. This causes their brains to imagine a dress that's reflecting lots of light and therefore see white and gold. The problem is once they see it one way, it's hard for them to convince the brain otherwise. This is your world news. Have a warm and good week, and remember, be proud to be an American.
This has been your weekly roar.